through the wall?
In ruins. It's the first city that the children of Israel came to after God brought them through the River Jordan into the Promised Land. The Canaanites had already heard about what God had done through Israel, the tremendous defeats of their enemies in the desert, how he parted the Red Sea and miraculously brought the children of Israel through. Their hearts were melting in fear. This city was shut up tight, and the Israelites came to this city with no weapons, but they carried with them the Ark of God. God told them to march around the city once a day for 6 days, and the Ark went before them around the city. But on the seventh day, he said, march around the city 1 mile in circumference around this archaeological dig, and at the end of the seven times marching around, with the Ark of the Covenant leading the way, the priests blew the ram's horns, and the people gave a great shout, and the walls of the city came tumbling down by the power of God and his presence with the Israelites. And then the people went in and destroyed the city, because God's judgment had fallen on this land of Canaan because of the corruption of the people and their religion that sacrificed children on their altars. And God was cleansing the land, using the Israelites to do that, and then setting up this promised land that would be filled with the worship of him, justice in the land. And his hand was with Joshua and the people that day. And then Joshua gave a curse upon the city that God had brought, that the city would never be rebuilt again. And there you see, this city that is a mile wide, or a circumference of a mile long, has never been rebuilt since the days of Joshua, 1200 B.C.
There's those walls that came tumbling down.
It's true.
That's a true story. You singing about the truth, and there's those walls today. They're still down. Very good. And good song. Good job, dude. You're learning about God's word in your school. I love it. Cool.